got my first Pokemon today, and I cannot wait to fight and slay all the basic trainers in my way. I'm the predator.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy back for another episode of our Pokemon Insert Roots Randomized Nuzlocke. In the last episode, you guys, we made it here to Kepler Town. We got 4 encounters, all of which were pretty much trash. Well, then again, the Tyranger was not trash, but still, most of them were trash. We found Gym Leader Anastasia. We warned her about the incoming attack from the Perfection Cult. When dun dun dun, she's actually being attacked by the Abyssal Cult. So, today's episode, we are tasked with taking down the Abyssal Cult. So, if you are hyped for today's episode and are looking forward to me losing some Pokemon, leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and you will get to see me agonize in pain even more. But without further ado, let's get ourselves a quick team recap. I have not healed since the last episode. First up, we have Serene, the Togekiss, rocking out with Thunder Wave, the newly acquired Dazzling Gleam, Aura Sphere, and Air Slash. Lapis, the Vaporeon with Hydro Pump, Aurora Beam, Hyper Voice, and Aura Pulse. Wendy, our starter Pokemon, the Celebi, rocking out with Charge Beam, Confusion, Ancient Power, and Magical Leaf. I almost said Magical Beam and Charge Power. Wow. Edward, the Genesect, rocking out with Slash, Exism, Magnet Bomb, and Flame Charge. Mystic, the Delta Gardevoir, rocking out with Thunderbolt, Livewire, Calm Mind, and Ice Beam. And last but not least, Iblis, the Delta Volcarona, rocking out with Sludge Wave, Space Regen, Aura Sphere, and the two-turn Hyperspace Hope. So, with that, let's go heal up, because we are dangerously weak right now. Something I wonder. Ooh, I wonder. What should I wonder about? And you know, I actually haven't even explored the town. But that's besides the point. We're heading to Maelstrom 9. We're going on a trip in a little rocket ship. Okay, I assume I'm supposed to use Dive here. Are those static Pokemon? Okay, so we're gonna do this the same way I did with the Whirl Island encounters. Or whatever that area is right before the Whirl Islands. And they have random static Pokemon out there too. So I'll treat this just like that. Instead of counting all of them, we're just gonna count one. And I'm gonna go with the right one. And a can't Thunder Wave. Can you take an Air Slash? Yes you can. Oh, wait a minute. I just remembered. I'm not using the mic for my headphones, so you guys didn't hear me hit my headphones just now. Not that you even needed to know I hit my headphones just now. Don't know, not even know. Come on, Magnemite. Would you just get in the ball? You're in the red. You're in the red and you're just a Magnemite. Get in the ball. Thank you. Jeez. Let's see if this fits. Yes, it does. Danger Zone the Magnemite. Alright, so let's go. Actually, I want to check the Dex Nav real quick. Okay, so this is all just considered Maelstrom 9. is, I honestly wanted to know, like, is this just Maelstrom 9, or is this some other area? The Abyssal Base. Oh. Can we catch anything? Come on, back on. Anything? No? I'm gonna try one more time. So there's no encounters here. No, since I'm supposed to be a part of the Abyssal Cult, let's play our role and have a water type lead the team. Escape rope. Ooh, snatch that up. I'm not gonna lie, I actually really do like the new Abyssal Cult outfits. They're pretty nice. Pretty nice. And we have a lot of those. That new psychic. I'm supposed to still have. Yep, I still have a super potion. Exactly 50 points. Not bad. Not bad at all. Okay, let's go up first. Great, so I have to find something else now. So at least I know where we're supposed to be going. This is like fighting Team Aqua all over again. Oh, I didn't think you'd want to fight. It's not. Oh, you are a psychic type. And you have water absorbed. Okay. Yikes. Of course. Synchronous hits because. Synchronous is a very stupid attack. Because you can only use it against Pokemon of the same type. So, with it being a psychic type and a psychic type attack, it's resisted. Oh, hello? A Delta Clamperl? What type are you? Delta Clamperl is Dragon type. Bro, Okay, so we're obviously supposed to come here. Alright, so let's try going down this way. What's here? Wait, this is where I came in from. Okay. Wait, I'm going around in circles. I've been here. I snuck past him. Okay. So what exactly am I supposed to... Alright. I think I went up, so let's go this way. Okay, so I didn't go. Alright, so let's go up. Matter of fact, wait, is it up the way towards... Yep. Up is towards that green thing, so I have to go back down. Let's see, so we didn't go with this one here. Yep, we definitely didn't come here. Ultra ball. Burn here. All these force fields are actually just light screens from Audrey's Alakazam. That crystal shard I found for her makes them strong enough to keep people out. Oh. Delta Regidrock. Still weak to water though. Just a pile of sand. Reshiram is not that scary. Fire Dragon. Your Fire Dragon, and all we have for you is Reshiram. Of course, I'm paralyzed. Of course, I get paralyzed. And of course, Venus. Alrighty then. Can you go for a burn up again? Of course you fusion flare. Of course you do. Of course you do. Why wouldn't you? Great, so now I need a password. I'm taking a picture of that because I'm definitely not gonna remember how to, spell that. Good thing my phone is nearby. Proteus. Alright, so while I have this opportunity, let me heal up the team real quick. Cause we get into a battle, we are getting blown back. Idris is paralyzed. Let me use my last paralyzed heal.
Now I gotta find that room again. There we go. Password Proteus. Wait, why would the sewers be drained if they were around? I could have sworn the sewers were drained. Isn't that that area that we found a little while ago? Where is it? Where is it? Okay, now I'm just blindly running around. Aha! Can we get an encounter here? She took off her wetsuit. Okay, I'm gonna find it safe to assume that the game. No, I'm not even gonna think about it. Even though I've already thought about it, I'm not gonna think about it. Oh, you're kidding me. I can't leave this room. Okay, that's kind of stupid. How come Audrey can't enter her own? And then if that's the case, what was her wetsuit doing back there? Somebody took her wetsuit back there. We're doing some things with the wetsuit. Ooh, I'm snitching. Alright, so. I see something. You know what? I kind of want to go battle that last person. Just to see if they want to battle me. They don't want to battle. Oh, that's crazy. They don't want to battle. I'm not battling you. Okay, let's save the game. Hang on, did that change because I'm dressed as a female right now? Hang on, I want to see something. Let's change it to a scientist. Let's go to save. Yeah, that's crazy. All right, so the text changed because of that. I even look like an abyssal cultist on the trainer card. I look like a scientist on the trainer card. All right, what about as the cultist? A female cultist. That's what we are. We are a female cultist. Okay, so I think I might walk into this. But this is male, though. Whatever. Oh, we just took it off. Well, then. A blue skidoo? Oh, we can too.
Did you know that 97% of the ocean is unexplored? It covers the majority of the planet, and we barely know anything about it. We know more about the moon than the earth and the seas on earth. What kind of awesome Pokemon could exist down there? Have you heard of the Hoenn Calamity? About 30 years ago, when Kyogre was first summoned by Team Aqua, the weather went wild. Tons of things were raised from the depths of the ocean. Most of it was unimportant, bottles, shoes, maybe a few gems or pearls, and a rare, never-before-seen Pokemon. A squid that looked similar to Tentacruel, but with vastly higher stats. An evolution that only would occur in high water pressure. Jesus. A Pokemon with stats like that. A Pokemon with stats that rivaled legendaries. And further research shows there are hundreds of hundreds more. Of course, this was kept hush-hush. It would be awful if everyone knew that what creatures the ocean held. Everyone would be trying to catch these monstrosities, and with good reason. Fortunately, it turns out these Pokemon aren't nearly as strong out of the ocean as they are in it. Do you know why we're after Kyogre? It's incredibly powerful, and with a blue orb, it becomes one of the strongest Pokemon in the world. But do you know where its true talent lies? Kyogre is often considered as the deity of the sea, a real-life Poseidon. That's not an honorary title. Kyogre is the king in the most literal way. I'm not sure how, but it has the power to control and command other creatures of the sea. Sure, having Kyogre would be great, but having an entire army of deep-sea Pokemon, all with the strength of legendaries, we would be undefeatable. And now we have Lugia on the surface creating a storm to cover the world. With the surface flooded, my army will be stronger than ever. Kyogre is slowly calling forth the first of my beasts from the ocean, even deeper than where we are. One by one, beast by beast, the Abyssal Cult will grow stronger. I couldn't start until today, not until I had a power surge strong enough to power both Kyogre and Lugia. But now I have a shard of the very same crystal that once powered the Augur. I've lost everything in pursuit of this goal. My life, a child, and more. So you've come to stop me. I'll take care of you now before the first creature rises. You won't stand a chance. Ooh, her beautiful, beautiful theme music is playing again. Oh, by the way, Audrey, on my way in here, when I was snooping through the place, either one of your cultists or the scientists took one of your wetsuits into this back room. I don't know what they were doing with it, but I found it there on the table. I found a strand of your hair, so with that I was able to sneak in here, just so you know. So if I do lose this battle, you know that you have somebody in here doing stuff with your old wetsuit, just saying. She leads with a Glaceon while I lead with Lapis. You know what? This is perfect. We'll take this opportunity to set up Livewire. And she sets up the hill. As an ice type, that's resisted and you can't freeze me. And since I now know that you have Mirror Coat, I'm gonna get to +6. Imagine I had a Focus Sash and then Miracoded me. I'd be so upset. And you know, I don't even remember what Delta Gardevoir's move is.
What's Delta Gardevoir's ability? Clear body, okay. Oh. I was about to say. Great, so we gotta set up the live wire again. Alright, but it's all good. I don't think Helios has anything to hurt us with. Quick attack. Oh boy, I'm so scared. Giraffaru. Easy kill. Oh, it outspeeds. It outspeeds, and it is a ground type. Yikes, 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 yikes. And it roto to it. Wait. It roto tillered into play rough? Okay, I'm gonna have to check the recording on that, because that was weird. Not bad. It roto tillered into play rough. Whatever. How embarrassing. I can't believe I lost to you. You got 6-0'd. You got swept. You got ran through by Mystic. Don't mess with Mystic. Mystic out here taking lives. Gardevoir is one of the greatest Pokemon of all time. And I don't even have the Delta Gardevoir yet. Is there even a Delta Gardevoir? I hope there is. How embarrassing. I can't believe I lost to you. It doesn't matter though. I can see the water stirring already. Oh, I see it too. My army will soon arise. And then, river, and then... What on earth was that? And then? Who are you? How did you get in here? Your Alakazam fainted. The barriers are gone. Who are you? Wait a second. Aren't you that man from Sonata Hills? The leader's father? I guess your treatment didn't go well. You couldn't be more wrong. I feel better than ever. I've been improved, empowered, and I want the world to join me. I extend to you the same offer, Audrey. Forget this ocean army. Join me. All I ask in return is that crystal. All you ask? Are you insane? You want me to release the only thing keeping Kyogre in check? I don't know how you got down here, but you better turn your weird tentacle-covered tail around and leave. Now. It wasn't me that wanted you to join. What? What are you on about? I want to help heal the world. You want to rule it. Our goals differ. You would not be of help to me. Having Pokerus is a must. Is a most illuminating experience. Things are revealed. You remember things that were suppressed. What are you getting at? For example, the memory of a mother who abandoned her child, of being raised by someone else because his mother chose a Pokemon over him. Even after remembering all that, Damien still wanted you healed. Damien? You mean... That's right. Your son. Dun dun dun! Plot twist! Why is Damien covered in the Deoxys thing? Oh my, Damien, you're all grown up now. You're like him. You're one of them. What happened to you? I left you. This is all my fault. You can make it up to him. This is what he wants. Just give him the crystal. But why? Why would you want that? The crystal is a power source for Pokemon. And we're just as much Pokemon as human now. She's not giving it. Take it, Damien. What? No, that's the only... No. Kyogre, no, get back, don't move. Please. I am so confused. What? You did the right thing, Damien. Everyone thought you were going to snap, but you're going to help me heal the world. You'll be a hero, Damien. Everyone will look up to you, not down. Let's go. We have people to help. So Kyogre got her in the end? That's horrifying. It's appropriate, but still, that's seriously incredible. You actually beat a cult leader, and disbanded her cult. You're the first person since the Augur to pull that off. I heard about your friend. If whatever's affecting Mauld is affecting him too, then I promise we'll find a way to help you. I've been doing some research into the Pokerus virus. I'll tell Nora about it, and we'll work on finding a solution together. I know you're worried about him. The decisions he's making, they aren't his. It's the virus talking. Don't do anything rash, okay? I'll leave you here. I have a gym to run. And from what I hear, you have one to visit. Anastasia should be ready for you in Kepler. Thanks for telling me about this. Let me know if you see my father or your friend again. Hello? Excuse me? What was this? One down. The mistress will be most pleased. The shards will return to us. Earth, it's almost time to come back to the mirror. Excuse me? So wait, does that mean I'm back in Sonata City? I'm back in Sonata City. Are you kidding me? No, Pika Taxi, take me to Kepler. Take me to Kepler. I refuse to walk back there because there's trainers that I skipped and I don't want to battle them. Okay, so the next place is Nazca Town, Hikari Town, Selene City, Ramos Town, what's this place? Gaia Town, Amphitrite City, Daeran Town, Mount Rose, Rose Crater, Daeran Cave, Arrow Town, Nexapori. Okay, what's here? Oh, it's the secret lab. Okay. You know what? I'll explore the town real quick. Nope. I'm gonna make that two separate episodes. Let's let Audrey and her defeat be one episode, and then the gym be the next. Oh, we just got Surf. Yes, so I can get rid of Hydro Pump. Nice, we can get rid of Hydro Pump on Vaporeon. This isn't physically possible. That is not physically possible. Can we go to the left? You'd think she'd give us permission after what we did for the town. Whatever. Let's see, what else can we explore real quick? Mm-hmm. any electric and fire type Pokemon. Electric and fire type Pokemon? Do I have anything like that? Do I have an electric fire type? Augur's actually a cultist? He's running the reader behind our backs? Wake up, Meripul. Hello? What? So this man knows, but everybody thinks he's crazy. That's crazy. Hang on, couldn't I get over there the other... Yeah, I was able to get over there before. How come I can't get over there now? So, it looks like the only thing left to do is to take on the gym. Okay, so with that... today's episode is a little bit shorter than normal, but hey, it's all good. So with that, I'm gonna wrap things up here. If you like today's story-filled episode, leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and I shall be back for more.